This is this week's paid promoter snippet. I've been on a grind trying to get my head. Do it my way, don't need a cosign. Thought you'd be in a picture when it came time, but that ain't how the stars align. Had to get it on my own head. Had to get it on my own. Had to get it on my own. Had to get it on my own. Like what you heard, be sure to click down below in the description. And also feel free to email us at complexambition401@gmail.com. BAM! Look,
they gonna love me for my ambition.
What lies behind you and what lies in front of you pales in comparison to what lies inside of you.
Complex ambition.
Beautiful music, painted pictures, this be my vision.
Shout out to everybody out in the world. You guys could be anywhere in the world, but you're here with us again. Complex Ambition. So,
my name is YI.
And this week we are bringing you a reaction and review to the Mr. Goddamn Yummy. He's back again with another single off of this album that's officially announced changes coming Valentine's Day.
Valentine's Day. Very exciting. You got the little YouTube little series that he's doing.
Yeah.
And getting the fans excited, but... After Yummy, I wasn't too excited. I was excited. I swear to God, I was excited. I wanted to see his approach after
not
dropping music for a long time, years. He came with Yummy. We were very critical of it.
Jesus.
You can check that video out. It's out now. We're here now with Mr. Quavo. I think he snippeted this a while back.
Yeah, a while back. And people were like, oh, okay.
I wasn't excited when I heard it.
Is hip-hop on this, I guess?
Wasn't excited when I heard it.
Listen, we don't know what's going on. There's been obviously a hit and miss, actually a full miss on his part. When it comes to this promotion of the forcing of the Yummy, and it's kind of like a trend now, because now you had Selena doing it, and we don't know who's next. Someone's going to be next trying to do this stream Yummy like it's the fucking the Bible. Like, it's like, we got to, if not.
So you feel as
damn.
If... You feel as if... Yummy, he was pushing it down our throats?
Pushing it down our esophaguses, no. As if it was a penetration of the penis to the mouth.
Yeah.
And the phallus shape was called Yummy. We've had enough of this shit. this time, we have a single called Intentions. What are your intentions? Because Jesus, my nigga, damn! For starters, we had the thumbnail. It's a lot of black people in the thumbnail.
Let me see.
Bro, it's a black. He's in a black neighborhood with Quavo. He's the only white person. It's like a cul-de-sac. I don't know.
You know what I'm saying? He did grow up in Canada. It's the hood. Speaking of seriously now, pop stars have done this before, where they
100%
borrow from hip hop because now hip hop is pop, and I don't want to feel like our people are being used here, bro. So
yeah.
We're just gonna see it. We're gonna try to see your intentions and
literally. To the song Intentions.
He was born in Saudi Arabia. Her mom worked 3 jobs to bring her children to the US for a better life. Immediately, he's going for the ethos?
Yeah.
The emotional pull. I
My
think
mom
that's the ethos.
Was forced to just get us out of a situation that wasn't the safest.
Her intention is to have a family graduate. To get a class, she borrows a car, drives a bus 2-3 hours each way.
Raised in a foster care system, became the mom when she was 19. She escaped an abusive relationship in a safe home for her
kids. I didn't know how to ask for help. I just want other people to have a place where they can go to and talk to each other.
Where poetry met me back in 2000.
Spit that shit.
Angel left the Sparrow Heights for slow writing. She experienced all this with her children and grandchildren.
Because this fear now, I say to myself, is real now. So let's deal.
Man, the girl on the track, what the fuck is going on? Justin Bieber and Quavo.
Too perfect, you don't need no filter. Gorgeous, make them drop dead, you a killer.
Imagine a bunch of hired actors. That better not be, it can't be.
We might have been wrong. You know what I'm saying? It might be good.
It might be good, but listen.
Why didn't you drop this in the fucking beginning, you motherfucker?
Yeah.
Instead of saying, hey, Roddy Ricch, you got the first one.
Listen.
Calm the fuck down. You should have calmed the fuck down if you're going to be dropping music like this.
It should have just stuck to the music.
Fuck. Nigga, they know who you niggas are.
This is Alec Baldwin's podcast.
Nigga, we know you're sucking. Boy. That mustache's gotta go. Make sure that you
don't need no mentions. Yeah, these are my only intentions. Got everywhere, don't worry about no refusal. Don't need a sponsor, no.
That's great. I thought Quay was gonna do a hook. I'm just realizing Justin already did the hook.
So I feel, act like you know that you are.
Sorry, that's Barry.
He said, I heard you're a pillar in this community. Is that true?
Get you some studio time so that you can.
Oh, they are, as they should.
It's on now.
I came here to achieve my success till I attest to street life distress. Now
fuck.
I put me down to damn. Sleep on this pillow of concrete.
Everyone has
damn! Put her on Rhythm and Flow season 2. My God!
Oh, 500,000 in each one?
Commute.
What if I told you that you wouldn't have to worry about that anymore?
I don't know about this. I don't like that. Why is it doing that?
I don't know how I feel. I don't know how I feel inside. Like God's plan, but kind of different. Like a junkie Jonas.
What would you do?
What is this? What is this? This is an ABC television show?
It's for you.
That's hard to take care of if you're poor. The parts are expensive. Quavo. Don't need mentions. Fan goals, they don't want to be independent. 50% attention, we need commitment. It's a blessing, cause we both get it. Buddy Rich, you had a good run.
Wow,
I'm shot.
My intentions are the same now as many years ago.
My intention is to help kids who are less fortunate.
Is to give back.
Judy Vaughn, and I'm founding director of Alexandria House. My intention is to speak truth to power.
Thank you guys so much for having us. Quavo and I, it meant so much to us just being here. Thank you guys so much.
The intentions are obviously good intent, very positive intentions, a beautiful thing.
I don't know if I can say that. Intentions is intrinsic. You know what I'm saying?
Man.
The manifestation of whatever intention they had was positive. It was beautiful. But what I perceive...
There's a lot of scripted shit.
A lot of scripted, and that makes me wonder the intentions. Obviously, you need to have sometimes things scripted or whatever because of the flow. Niggas didn't got time, you know what I'm saying? Don't have that much time. I just don't...
That shit was... It definitely gave me God... From the beginning, it was like God's plan vibes.
We might have to look back.
But Drake didn't even
plan.
Talk one time in God's plan. He didn't talk one time.
He talks to family.
Yeah, but he didn't talk like, oh, yeah, he did say something, right? Yeah, like, on the mic. Damn, so it literally is some God playing and shit.
But why was God playing so much more... why?
It was, like, more authentic. I don't know. It just felt, like, more awkward, more authentic. This one was... I don't know. Justin, especially because Justin was, like, the one that was the talking. And you had the girls, like, just doing casual stuff at their houses. It's like, oh, they probably just told him, oh, what could you... Do laundry or do homework, and we'll record you. Like that whole vibe. That was a different day of shooting.
Yeah, then he came out of the car.
Drake
and walked
didn't do
up
no
to the
shit
porch.
Like that.
Hey guys, they were like, "Yo, you're gonna meet the girls at the house.
Yeah,
just say a couple words, and then we're in and out, Justin.
Surprise,
okay?
Surprise. We're gonna surprise them." It's like it's too much. It's too much. Like,
and he didn't need Quavo on the song. Quavo came so late. I don't know.
I thought Quavo was gonna be the hook.
He was great in it.
He was great.
He was fantastic. It was beautiful.
Really
I love that.
Probably
Quavo
the best
was
he's
part
been
of
in a while.
It. Yeah, but I don't find him necessary. I'm gonna be real as fuck right here. Didn't find him necessary. I thought it was a ploy by the record label. Yeah. I didn't even know if Justin himself was like the mastermind behind this, because that last label right there makes me feel as if that Def Jam was like. Fucking going crazy with this shit.
They put money on this shit.
Yeah,
like
they
was,
put mad.
It was
oh
a
my God.
Casino.
Yeah, and that's 200,000. Yeah, that's part tax deductible. Listen, and that's the fucking shit that bothers me. We just don't know the intentions, and that's what bothers me, because it looks too scripted. It looks way too drawn up, planned out.
Yeah.
It looks too
polishing the image. Or
polishing the image. You should have started like this, and you fucked yourself, because we saw your live videos doing yummy and telling people you're not even listening to these motherfuckers when they talk to you, Justin.
And how you gonna go from that?
You just say stream yummy, stream yummy.
You're going from that to this yummy,
super sexual
oral sex song. To then this,
and like, I'm not saying we're not bashing the song and saying that you can't talk about those things, but the juxtaposition, like, there is not really working.
You should have rolled out with this. You should have rolled out with this,
especially after hiatus, bro.
And you're such a big artist that I don't even think that you necessarily need singles. But if you're gonna do a single, man, like, you have to realize what that can encapsulate if you've been on a hiatus for so long.
That's could have just came out with an album.
That's like a first impression right away.
Yeah.
You could just drop the album, mm-hmm. or you could have just dropped this shit, the intention mm-hmm. shit, mm-hmm. because you had the yummy, and like, you're in the face of, you know, social media fucking burial. The fucking, like, it's like it's over for Justin. Oh.
But and the reality is that Justin's going to continue to sell records, sell out stadiums. He's going to fucking keep on going, but maybe not garnering the new demographic he wants to garner, or at least the label wants him to garner. Especially now in this age where hip-hop is controlling everything, mm-hmm. and the black and brown kids are running it. You know what I'm saying?
100%.
They want that audience. You know, maybe Justin really didn't have that audience, but you have your audience. Love him. What I can say is this. The Kalani song, was that a video?
No, they had no video. It was like a random drop, like a single, but not really pushed. It was during the middle of the week.
I didn't understand the Kalani drop. Yeah. I'm going to be very critical with Justin. I'm not going to take shit from motherfuckers at his level.
He's the hierarchy of pop stardom. No. So it's like, you got to be critical, because, like, bro, you're supposed to be the example of what is to be, you know, followed. Like, what are we going to follow?
And we had high expectations for you, high hopes. Bro, I was following you and I was excited for you. And I was excited to see this journey.
I thought it was going
to
be revolutionary to the music world.
Yo, in Christendom. And now that Kanye is doing his whole...
Jesus is king.
What was it called? An evangelical... pursuit. I thought you were gonna ride with him, and that would have been dope. And we saw Jesus is King merch, and you know what I'm saying, like, I was excited. But you're gonna hit me with this one over the head.
I can't even say I'm excited for the album anymore because of this reason.
Jeez, man.
Because of the letdown.
I wish the motherfucker just made music because he wanted to make music, and not.
Man.
I don't know. That's what I feel.
And when you title it Intentions, it's like, it's I don't know. I don't think it even deserves, like, a deeper dive. Like, it's just, like, it's, like, it is what it is. Like, we saw it. Like, people are, I don't know, you can't deny that from watching the video.
Did you feel something?
No, I didn't
feel nothing, dog. Yeah. I wanted to.
I respect the move. If it was actually done, like, the actual donations, that's dope. You know, it was beautiful.
Absolutely.
But at the end of the day, I don't know if it should have been done on video, should have been made the premise of the music video when the song is... universal, but it's not necessarily just making a song about helping others and just being that sort of generous and donating. That's not what it's not a donation song.
Oh, inauthentic. And that's the biggest factor in this game. It's a great song.
There's way worse music out there. This is a song that has the potential to obviously chart and work with his demographic. But We're gonna leave it there. Justin, Quavo, you guys let us know. Comment down below, how do you guys feel about Intentions? Did it have good intentions? Do you see our intentions? What are your intentions? Are you here just to listen to music, or do you just skim through it? Like Jay-Z says. Are you breaking this down? Do you see what we see? Or are you guys just riding his cock? Because let's ride it to the moon. No. Hop off.
Yay, he's helping people. Oh my God, I love it.
Aside from that, what's going
on? I need authenticity. I need to feel that shit.
What's going on?
Oh, man. I really wanted to like it. And we're not trying to kill Justin, man. Like, come on, man. I love JB, man.
Man.
That felt inauthentic.
Get in the car, Justin. Get in the car, please. Please, hop in. You're welcome to join us. That's all we really have to say. James Corden, you hopped in with him, but you guys were really driving the car. And that's another fallacy going on.